AXS TV presents Matisyahu.
I come walking through this kingdom of time.
This is All Access, your backstage pass to the biggest events in music.
The other side.
I just always loved music. I listened to music and I performed and I acted and sang as a kid and stuff. And then as I got older, it just felt like that's what I am. He got a spot on Jimmy Kimmel, was pretty cool. That was in 2004 maybe. And the performance was really energetic and something new that a lot of people, obviously no one had seen before. Like Hasidic man rapping and singing with that kind of energy and that kind of, I think, authenticity. It was something for people to wrap their heads around. When I first began touring, I was living in Crown Heights in Brooklyn. I was just getting married. I remember when I bought my first van, because I had been in yeshiva for 2 years and I had no money and I wasn't even paying to be in the yeshiva. I was just living there and eating there and everything. I did most of the driving in the van, and then obviously I was, you know, helping the band, you know, unload gear, and at the end of the night, load gear. I mean, the schedule, the day would go like, you would sleep in a hotel, you have to figure out how to back your van into the hotel in a way that no one could break into it, because we didn't have an alarm on it. I remember I had a cooler next to me, and I wasn't a vegetarian then, and I had brought vacuum-packed, like, meat in the cooler, and I was trying to figure out how to be, you know, kosher, and I would, And the meat started rotting like about 2-3 weeks into the tour, and I forgot about it. And then at some point, I think the bass player just took the whole cooler and threw it out the window on the highway. When we'd be playing in the club, little bars, and there would be this interesting mix of people, because at that point, I would say at least half the audience was, you know, Jewish or religious. And they never come to those kind of bars or anything. I think initially there was a reggae crowd that was into it. Those were like the two people that were at the show. Then after Jimmy Kimmel, after radio and Bonnaroo, and as things started to grow, then I noticed my crowd started to diversify and started to become much more mixtures, to the point where, you know, you'd see one beard or two beards in the audience. All of a sudden we're on planes and we're one day in California, then the next day we're in Brazil, and then the next day we're back to New York. And then, you know, the first years was like really a flash, but I was kind of riding the wave basically, and I was just trying to keep my head above the water. So you jump in, you've got no clue what's flying. But, you know, a decade doing something, you get a sense of and a feel for it in all the aspects of it. I was singing one day, and I was looking at the people in the audience, and then I was realizing, like seeing the way that they're singing it and talking, how people, they give meaning to the song. When people are thriving off of a song or getting energy or inspiration, whatever it is, and it's helping them in their lives, they kind of like infuse the song with meaning. Like, I might have thought, okay, one day there'll be peace and that'll be a great thing, I'm gonna write a song about that. But like, for the veteran who had his like leg blown off in Iraq, and that song somehow got him through that month in the hospital when he was there, and his idea of what peace is and war, you know, and he put that into the song, you know, and the song has that now, you know what I mean? And there's thousands of stories like that. It's so much bigger than like anything that I could do, and that's a very comforting thought, you know.
Check out Matisyahu, only on AXS TV.